Hello, I'm Eleftheria Drigga. I'm working with Elias Kouloridis, and I'm going to talk about the properties of active galactic nuclei in clusters. This is a joint project with the XXL Survey and the Hyper Supreme CAM collaboration. There's no need to say a lot about AGN, but I would like to point out that they are the most energetic phenomenon in the universe. AGN are different from inactive galaxies because of the supermassive accreting black holes in galaxy centers. And as a result, X-ray observations provide the most efficient way for detecting AGN compared to other wavelengths. In this project, we want to study AGN in clusters of galaxies, which are the largest gravitational bound systems in the universe. Clusters of galaxies contain 50 to 100 galaxies, and their mass consists of 5% of galaxies, 10% of hot intracluster medium, and 85% of dark matter. While the values of cluster masses are 10 to the 14 to 10 to the 15 masses of Sun. Moreover, the gas in the cluster gravitational potential emits X-rays, and that's why we detect clusters are X-ray extended sources. At the same time, AGN have a strong relation with galaxy evolution. There is also strong evidence that they correlate with a large-scale structure, and because, as I said before, clusters are the largest gravitational bound systems, they are both an ideal laboratory at the AGN and large-scale structure connection. There are some advantages of X-ray selection. First of all, candidate clusters are not affected by projection phenomena. Secondly, from temperature and luminosity measurements, we can easily approximate the cluster mass. And as a result, we can have an important radius for galaxy cluster studying. The radius are 500. R500 is a radius where the mean density is 500 times the critical density of the universe at the cluster's redshift. So it's different for each cluster, the value fluctuates between 300 kiloparsec and 1 megaparsec, depending on the mass. There are two major things that we observe while we study AGN in galaxy clusters. The first one is ram pressure stripping by the hot intracluster medium. Namely, we see differences between cluster AGN and field AGN. In massive clusters, we find less AGN in the center and more jellyfish galaxies that can be found in the central region of galaxy clusters, where the hot intracluster medium causes the stripping of the gas of cluster galaxies. The result is the stopping of star formation and possibly of the black hole accretion, and that leads to a reduced fraction of AGN in clusters. The second major thing that we observe is AGN triggering in the outskirts of galaxy clusters. A significant excess of X-ray point sources is found in the outskirts of clusters. This can be due to the high density of galaxies that leads to a higher merging rate and thus AGN, or to the presence of infalling small groups from filaments where galaxies have already been pre-processed. In this project, we use data from the XXL survey. The XXL survey is the largest XMM Newton project approved to date, serving two 25 square degree fields, the northern one and the southern one. The two fields have extensive multi-wavelength coverage from X-ray to radio. Until now, approximately 450 new galaxy clusters have been detected up to redshift 2 and about 2000 AGN up to redshift 4. You can see here from the southern field The red circles that correspond to the detected clusters and the luminous spots that that are the detected AGN. From the total cluster catalog of the XXL, we select spectroscopically confirmed clusters in the northern XXL field, which is covered by deep hyper supreme camera cam observations. This allows a detailed morphological classification of AGN hosts up to at least 0.5 redshift. And here you can see two images from the 8.2 meters Borrow telescope in Hawaii. Now I present two distributions. One, the first one is the redshift distribution, and then the mass distributions. Distribution for from our sample, which consists of 165 spectroscopically confirmed galaxy clusters from the northern XXL. But with this joint project with XXL and HSC, we want to study AGN interactions, looking for tidal tails or disturbed morphologies. We want to study host morphology type, if they are spiral, elliptical, or have a ring morphology, or etc. And the spectra. We visually inspect and analyze our sample, mainly with SDSS, but also with VIPERS or AAT. Proceeding below, you can see two images. The first one is from HSC and the second is from SDSS. In order to see the comparison between the details that we can extract from the HSC, obviously the resolution is much better. And for the same AGN host galaxy, we can see an irregular morphology in the HSC and a simple elliptical morphology with SDSS in redshift 0.49. Some more AGN host images from HSC with an important, with an interesting morphology. They are all with extracted with I-band photometry. We can also see a spiral one. We can see some tidal tails in two cases, and irregularities that we could not see with SDSS, for example. So HSC is ideal for thorough study about the morphology of AGN host galaxies. Some more examples with HSC images with the corresponding SDSS optical spectra. They are both narrow line cases. The first one is with the low redshift, and the second one is at high redshift and probably a merger one.
You have 3 minutes left.
Okay. We also want to make an X-ray analysis. Okay, I proceed. These are two examples with interacting and merging host galaxies that we are interested. We were very interested in this, in finding these cases. And here are our first, our preliminary results, statistical results. They are they show the fraction of interacting AGN per radius, and the right one is with mass distinction. The blue one are groups, and the orange are more massive clusters. And we found that we saw that the interactions are related to the AGN triggering in clusters according to previous studies. despite the fact that in the center of the clusters, especially in massive clusters, there are only few AGN, these AGN present an important merging rate. And last but not least, interacting AGN presents similar mass distribution in all beans, except from bean 2, where it's the first outskirts region. And we know from previous literature, from previous studies, that there in outskirts, there is an excess triggering of AGN. We definitely want to compare this sample with two control samples, one with field AGN and another one with simple galaxy cluster, with simple galaxies from the clusters, in order to make more secure conclusions. Thank you.
Thank you, Eleftheria, for this talk. I don't see questions yet. And I was wondering if you could please go back on slide, just to read it a little bit further, because that changed once. So you see more or less a fixed fraction of AGNs, irrespective of...
Hear you.
No, I was just reading out loud what you're showing here.
Okay.
So, okay, I have no question for you, really. It was pretty clear what you had to say. Adonis has a question, otherwise, after
here. Yeah, I'm just wondering about the redshift information. So how many of those galaxies do you know by redshift measurements that they are cluster members? And how,
they
for
are,
how many?
They are all... the clusters that we have in our sample, they are all confirmed clusters spectroscopically. And the AGN, most of our AGN are spectroscopically confirmed. So they for sure belong to the cluster. And we have some that are photometric. There is no available spectra. But in these... fraction in these histograms, there are only the spectroscopic ones.
Okay.